Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Jacob Zarega, and I am the band manager for the Symphonic Band that is here behind me. Now, I know that you've heard a lot of people talking, so I'll keep it brief, but every adjective already used, I'm going to echo it. These kids have been fantastic. Okay, everything that you would want your kids to be, they have been. They've been quiet, they've been respectful, they've been attentive, and most of all, they have been fantastic musicians. Can we please give a round of applause for them? They have been working under the direction of Dr. Michael Stewart, who, funny enough, was my college band director, so this has been a treat for me as well. But he is currently the W.J. Julian Endowed Director of the Pride of the Southland Marching Band and is the Associate Director of Bands at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, Go Vols. And he does everything. He does marching band, he does pep bands, he teaches undergraduate classes, and we are in for a real treat, ladies and gentlemen. He is a phenomenal director, and I am so fortunate that these kids have learned so much from him. So without further ado, Dr. Michael Stewart and the District 16 Symphonic Band.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and first off, thank you all for coming out and spending a Saturday afternoon with us here and getting a chance to hear some band music. Again, my name is Michael Stewart, one of the directors of the University of Tennessee and director of the Pride of Southland Band. It has been a tremendous honor to come out here and spend the last 48 plus hours working with these amazing students. You've heard everybody talk about it over and over, and there's a reason. They have been unbelievable to work with since Thursday night when we first passed out this music. And everything I have thrown at them, they have just continued to just take in, soak it up, and just work with me every single moment. Every rehearsal has been a true pleasure. And I just can't say enough about this group behind me. That first piece you heard was a fun little dance here that we've been working on the last couple days, Fandango. And this is going to go into a piece, Remembering the Remarkables, by Grace Baugher, who was a former student of mine at the University of Tennessee, has since become a pretty famous composer at this point and really rising in the world of music education and in bands. So we'll do this next piece for you, Remembering the Remarkables. Thank you. That is Corleaners and Dance is one of the band standards. I know all the directors in the room have probably either heard and or played and or conducted that
And one that I wanted to break out for this, especially it was composed by Ron Nelson, who recently passed away, and just wanted to kind of play that as well, an homage to him, certainly a favorite in the band world. We're going to do a movement from the Delta by William Grant Still, coming up here, Spiritual, movement number 2. We're going to follow that by Hymn to the Infinite Sky by Yagisawa.
Thank you.
Once again, thank you all for coming out. Before we do our last piece, Arabesque, I wasn't lying when I said I just kept throwing music at them, and they just kept playing, just constant. The students behind me worked just tirelessly for the last couple days. I told them yesterday, look, we're gonna have to woodshed a lot of this music if we're gonna play it, and they just hunkered down. A lot of them worked extra on the side, or took it home, or worked during breaks to be able to play some of the music that we've played for you this afternoon. None of this is possible without the directors that they've been working with, from sixth grade, middle school, high school. We are the fortunate ones at the collegiate level where we get to do what we do because somebody has started them in band, or because you, as family members, have supported these students throughout the process. Without that, without them learning Hot Cross Buns and Essential Elements, number 58, Hard Rock Blues, I still remember that. Without starting those programs, we can't do what we do. I know this may hurt some of you, but we can't play Rocky Top of Tennessee if somebody doesn't teach them those songs first. We can't play this music in front of you. And Arabesque, you're gonna hear, Arabesque was a push. This is a piece that I don't always do with honor bands unless I have some sort of confidence that the technique is there and that they can play what we need to play. And these students just knocked it out of the park. I'm so proud of the way they worked. But before we go on, I do just want to take a moment. I know they've been recognized, but directors, can you help me give a round of applause for these amazing people? It's been truly an honor to come out here. I get to go all over the country. I'm very fortunate to be able to go do events like this. What happens here is not normal. You all need to know that. The support from Loudoun County, the support from the administration, from the community, everybody, the teachers are just phenomenal. And I really enjoy just getting to talk to them and hear just how things run and how they operate. And this is unusual in a very, very, very good way. And I just want to continue. You've heard all the administrators, and from an outsider's standpoint, continue to support what's going on here. This is not normal. And I hope that communities like this will spread around the country and will continue to show what happens if you continue music. I've talked to the students over and over and over. They've had some amazing questions this week about what happens after high school. We talked about continuing to play. Talked about a 90-year-old trombone player I thought was dead next to me, but apparently not. He played forever. The guy just kept going, and we talked about how this is something that you can do well beyond high school. No matter what field of study, there's a place for you to continue playing. We just want to continue that. Again, I want to thank you all for spending an afternoon with us. I know we had a lot of music here. They've done an amazing job. I just want to thank the students one last time publicly because they were great to work with. So respectful, and just it's a true joy. It makes it that much more fun when we can have an experience like this. So, students, thank you so much. And if you would, please help me thank this band one more time for coming out. Thank you.